Dear students, welcome back in my class of CIS 3158 Mobile Applications and Game Development. We are in week 7 and in this week we are discussing Minimax search techniques. This is part 2 video lecture of week 7. And in this week, I have given the aim is to explore Minimax search, refactoring of code. We completed this in part number 1. And we are going to discuss backtracking and its merit for the game development in part 2, that is in this video lecture. And in part 3, we'll discuss the working of Minimax search technique. So in the next part, I will explain this. These two I will cover in the part 3 video lecture. As I said, the agenda for this part, that is part 2, is to understand backtracking and its merit for the game development. So in the next slide, I have highlighted what is the meaning of backtracking. So backtracking means you are moving in one direction and you are achieving the milestone. So these line indicates the milestones you are achieving, and all of a sudden after reaching to some milestone, let's say M7, you realize that you are moving in a wrong direction, or you cannot move further. It means that here you reach to a end and it is called as dead end. You cannot move, you cannot take the next move at this stage. So what you will do, you will move back and you will explore at this stage. After moving back, you will explore the possibility for moving to the next step. If you will get the any move at my milestone M3, then you will take the that move. Otherwise, you will again move back. You will explore the same thing. You will explore the possibilities to move at my milestone 2. If you will get any state to move, you will move. Otherwise, you will move back. So this process of moving back and exploring the possibilities to move further is known as backtracking. And it helps this moving back and exploring the possibilities, searching for the new state, it helps in finding or exploring all the possible states. So applying this approach, you can explore all the different possibilities you can apply in order to find out the solution for a given problem. So what is backtracking? Backtracking is a general algorithmic technique. So it is not like we will move randomly. We'll apply some rule for moving forward or moving backward. And based on the rule, based on the condition, based on the criteria which you will set in your method, you will move forward or you will move back. This is the idea. And backtracking considers searching every possible combination. Like I mentioned in my example, first you will move forward by if you will get new state and there is no violation of the rule or the criteria, then you will keep on moving forward. But if you will find the dead end, or you will not get any direction, you will not get any possibility to move forward, then what you will do, you will move back to the previous state. So this is the previous state. So what you will do, you will apply the same approach here and you will try to figure out new possibilities at this state. If you will get new possible state, then move to the new possible state and repeat the same process of moving forward. If not, then you will move back and you will explore the new possibilities at this state. If you will get new state here, then move to the new state. Otherwise, move back to the initial state and explore the new possibilities at this stage. So this is what we are doing. We are exploring all possible combinations to find the solution for any problem. And the third point is saying that it is used for optimization problem, because in optimization problem we want to reduce the cost, sometimes maybe cost, sometimes maybe time, sometimes maybe distance or any other factor. So that is why we want to explore all the possible combinations to reduce the cost, to reduce the time, to reduce the distance. If your criteria is benefit, then increase the benefit. So we will explore the possible combination to increase the benefit. So that is why backtracking plays a central role for optimization problem or for gaming to explore new states. So that is why backtracking is very, very important, and the idea is very simple. In the beginning, we will set the criteria for moving forward. If the criteria is there is no violation in the criteria, then keep on moving for in forward direction. If you are reaching to a dead end or there is no further state available where you can move, then what you will do? You will move back to the previous state. After reaching to the previous state, you will explore new possibilities at the previous state. If you will get, move to that state. If not, then further move back to the previous state. So this is how you will explore all searching possibilities to find out the solution for a given problem. In order to make the concept more clear for backtracking, I have given one example, and this is one of the popular example, and it is known as four queens problem. So the idea here is you have been given four queens, Q1, Q2, Q3 and Q4, and you have been given a task. The task is, this listed here, given a four queens, that is this, and you have been provided 4x4 chessboard. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 rows, 4 column, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 columns are given. So this is 4x4 chessboard. So that what you have to do, you have to place these queens Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 in this 4x4 chessboard. The criteria is, as I said, you need to set the criteria in the beginning. The criteria is no two queens are on the same row. So in one row, like here, you cannot place two queens. So this is the first criteria. Second criteria is you cannot place two queens in the diagonal, in the column or in the row. Another thing is if you have placed Q1 here, so you cannot place here or here. That is in both major and minor column. So this is minor diagonal and this is major diagonal. So these all are the criteria. So no two queens in the same row, not allowed. In column, again not allowed. In diagonal, both major and minor, these two are not allowed. So these all are the criteria and you need to place the queens. So what you will do, I have given, now we will solve this problem. So suppose this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 column, 1, 2, 3 and 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So I am placing my first queen in the first cell. So I will maintain a matrix also so that I can explain this. You can use this concept in the tutorial also. This is my matrix. In the beginning, all will be zero. And if you are placing the queen in any cell, then that particular cell in the matrix will be one. So you have placed queen here, so this will be one. So this cell will be one. So if Q1 is in row 1, so you cannot place any queen in the remaining cell in the row and here also in the column and in the diagonal also. So where you can place? You can place your queen here. That is Q2 can be placed here. So if you are placing Q2 in that block, it means that this cell will be 1. So if Q2 is here, you cannot place Q3 here. You cannot place Q3 here, you cannot place Q3 here, you cannot place Q3 here. So you can place your Q3 in this block, that is here. So if you are placing your Q3 in this block, it means that you cannot place Q4 in any of the block in row 4. So now you reach to a dead end, not allowed. Q4, placing of the Q4 is not allowed, and you reach to a end which is called as dead end. So at this stage, what you will do, and here the matrix will be 1. So at this stage, you will apply back tracking. Because you reach to a end which is known as dead end. So what you will do at this stage? Now let me start again. This is my chessboard. First row, first column, second column, third column and fourth column. First row, second row, third and fourth row. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four rows, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Four columns. So what I will do, and this is my matrix, solution matrix. 1, 2, 3 and 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4, four columns. So here in the beginning, all will be zero, all cells will be filled with zero. Now in the beginning, in the previous, what we did, we placed Q1 here and then we didn't get any place for placing Q4. Now in this case, we'll place Q1 here. So if we are placing Q1 here, it means that we cannot place Q2 here. We cannot place Q2 in the column. We cannot place Q2 in the diagonal, but we can place Q2 here. So this place will be 1 now. Now if Q1 is here, it means that we cannot place any Q in this column. If Q2 is here, we cannot place any Q in this column. So what we can do? We cannot place Q in the diagonal of Q2. So we are left with this state. So we will place Q3 here. So if we are placing Q3 in the first column, then this will be 1. And if Q3 is here, we cannot place Q4 here. We cannot place Q4 because this is the column for Q1. We cannot place Q4 in the fourth column. So which position is left with us? State, this state is available, that is column 3 is available for placing the Q4. So Q4 will be here and then this will be 1. So by exploring, by applying the backtracking, we got the chance to explore the chessboard again, and we got the solution. So here the solution can be represented as, so this is, sorry, I forgot to place one here. So the solution will be 2, that is this column, then comma 4, this column, then comma 3, this, 1, column number 1. 1, this is column number 1, and column number 3. So the solution is 2, 4, 1, 3. So this is backtracking. And it helps in exploring the possibilities to find out new search states. Thank you very much. I will explain how you can use backtracking.